Good evening, bettan. So today's session we are trying to do the problems on angular momentum and conservation of your angular momentum, bettan. Okay. So yesterday there was little bit technical problem with my WhatsApp, bettan. There is a reason it has been got glitch, and today it's fine. So let us try to start with the first problem of this one, bettan. See here. A solid cylinder of mass is given for me 20 kg. Rotates about an axis with an angular speed, that means omega. Omega is equals to 100 radians per second. Radius of the cylinder is 0.25 meter. Kinetic energy associated with the rotation. Kinetic energy associated with the rotation is how much? See, as there is no external force acting on the system, so torque will be zero. So when torque is zero, angular momentum is said to be conserved. But anyhow, we are just talking about your rotational kinetic energy. So directly, I can write the rotational kinetic energy formula. Kinetic energy will be equal to your half into I into your omega square. So that is equals to your half. What type of a body it is, beta? Solid cylinder. For solid cylinder, the moment of inertia is how much, beta? I of your solid cylinder will be equal to how much? Mr square divided by 2. Okay, so this will be equal to your m into your r square divided by 2 into your omega square. So that will be equal to your 1 by 2 into 2 is 4 into mass is nothing but equal to 20 into radius is 0.25 whole square into omega. Omega is your 100 whole square. That means 100 into your 100. See how much I'll be getting, beta? Am I audible to everyone? So this will become for me 1 by 4 into 20 into 0.25 means 1 by 4 beta. So it is 1 by 4 into 1 by 4 into this one is your 100 into your 100. So simplified, see how much I'll be getting. How much beta? This will become for me 2 into 10 to the power of 4. That means I can write this one as erase. So this will be 2 into 10 to the power of 5 divided by, this will be equal to how much beta? 4 into 4. 4, 4 is a 16, 16, 4 is a 64. So this will be equal to 64. So 2 divided by 64 is how much? 0.03125 into 10 to the power of 5. So that will be equal to 123 10 to the power of 5. So that will be equal to 3125 joules. Fourth option will be the answer. Clear? So 3125 joules will be the answer. Option D. Very good. Next one. A child is standing with the folded hands at the center of a platform, rotating about its central axis. The kinetic energy of the system is K. The child now stretches his arms so that the moment of inertia of the system becomes doubled. The kinetic energy of the system will become how much for me? So a child is standing with folded hands at the center of your platform, rotating at its central axis. Okay, this is your some platform. Child is standing at the center, okay, somewhere here, about its rotational axis. The kinetic energy of the system is K. Okay, kinetic energy will be equal to half into I into your omega square. So moment of inertia, we know for this body, it will be equal to how much? Okay, so it is again your M into r square divided by 2 into your omega square, isn't it? The child is now stretching his arms so that the moment of inertia of the system becomes doubled. That means I is becoming doubled. He has not given which body, no? So I can't take half of your mr square here. So I can directly take in terms of your moment of inertia. So kinetic energy is directly proportional to your moment of inertia. So I is doubled and omega is halved. Moment of inertia of the system becomes doubled. The child now stretches his arm so that the moment of inertia will double. The kinetic energy of the system will become how much? Since I is doubled, beta, omega will become how much, beta? Half, isn't it? So kinetic energy will become how much for me? Kinetic energy will become 1 by 2 times of K. That means this will become for me K by 2. B will be the answer. Isn't it? See here. So this is K dash, that is equals to half into, this is your doubled into, this one is your omega dash. There is nothing but omega dash square. So this will become for me, K dash is equals to your I into your omega dash square. So omega dash will be equal to how much, beta? Inversely proportional, isn't it? So that is the reason it is becoming for me K by 2. Next one. A circular disc rolls down an inclined plane. Okay, this is your circular disc. Which is rolling down an inclined plane. The ratio of rotation of the kinetic energy to the total kinetic energy will be equal to how much? The body is having V and also rotating. Can anyone try this one, beta? Anyone? Option B. Okay, chalo, let us try to see. Rotational kinetic energy formula is equal to how much, beta? Half into I into omega square. Circular disc, so for circular disc, the moment of inertia will become how much for me? M into your R square divided by 2 into your omega square. Isn't it? So V is equals to, we know, R into omega. So omega is equals to V by R. So this will become for me 1 by 4 into M into your R square into omega is equals to V square divided by your R square. This R square will get cancelled. 1 by 4 m into v square. This is your rotational kinetic energy. Translational kinetic energy will be equal to how much, beta? Translational kinetic energy will be equal to half into your m into your v square. Okay. Now, what will be the total energy? Total energy is sum of your translational plus of your rotational. So, translation is half into m into your v square plus this one is 1 by 4 into m into your v square. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 is how much, beta? 3 by 4 into m into v square. So therefore, what is asking in the problem, you see? What is asking is the ratio of translational kinetic energy to the total. Okay, translational kinetic energy to your total. Translational or rotational? Sorry, ratio of rotational. Rotational kinetic energy. So that means K rotational divided by total. So rotational, how much we got right now? 1 by 4 m into v square. Divided by total is 3 by 4 m into v square. Masses are same. Mv square will get cancelled. So that will become for me how much? 1 by 3. This 4 also will get cancelled. So 1 by 3 must be the answer. B will be the answer for that. Clear, beta? Sure. Next question. A mass M moves in a circle on a smooth horizontal plane with velocity V0 at a radius of your R0. Okay. A particle of mass m moves in a circle on a smooth horizontal plane with velocity v naught at a radius of your r naught. Radius is your r naught. The mass is attached to a string which passes through a smooth hole in the plane as shown in the figures. Hole it might be, not hole. The tension in the string is increased gradually and finally m moves in a circle of radius r naught by 2. The final velocity, the final value of the kinetic energy will be equal to how much? Okay. As a particle is moving in a circular path beta with an initial velocity, so net force acting on the system will be equal to your zero. So torque is also zero. So angular momentum is conserved. That means initial angular momentum must be equal to final angular momentum. So for a particle, mv naught into r must be equal to rotation m into v into at what radius beta? R by 2. So this m will get cancelled, isn't it? So this r and this r will get cancelled right now for me. So v naught will be equal to v by 2, or else v is equals to 2 times of v naught. Option B here. Okay, then what is asking? Final value of the kinetic energy. So final value of kinetic energy will be equal to how much beta? Kinetic energy is half into m into your v square. So it is equals to your half into m. V is equals to 2 into v naught whole square. That is equals to m by 2 into, this is 4 into v naught square. 2 ones are 2 twos are. So it will be 2m into your v naught square will be the answer. B. Done. Sure. Next one. The tangential force EF acts at the top of a thin spherical shell of mass m and radius of your capital R. The acceleration of this shell, if it rolls without a slipping, is how much? Okay. The tangential force acts at the top of a thin spherical shell of mass m and radius R. The acceleration of this shell, if it rolls without a slipping, is equal to how much? Now see here, beta. When a body has been moving in the front direction, force of the friction acting on this body will be in which direction, beta? Frictional force acting on this body will be in the backward direction. But as the force F acts on the top of the spherical shell of mass m and radius r, the acceleration of this shell, if it rolls without the slipping, so if it is rolling without the slipping part of relation, then frictional force will be acting in the front direction. That is F. That means your applied force plus of your frictional force will be equal to m into your a. This is my first part for translation motion. For rotation motion, beta, this is your force. So this is your perpendicular distance. And this one is also perpendicular distance. Force into perpendicular distance, that is f into r minus frictional forces, small f into your r, will be equal to your I into your alpha. So a is equals to how much for me, beta? A is equals to your r alpha for pure rolling. I told you this option already. So alpha will be equal to how much for me, beta? A by r. So that is equals to capital F minus small f into capital R is equals to your I. Alpha is equals to A divided by your R. Okay. That means capital F minus small f will be equal to I into your A divided by your R square. Okay, so this is my equation number 2. Okay, now add this equation 1 and 2, beta. Capital F plus small f is equals to your, if I'm adding 1 and 2, adding 1 and 2, that is capital F plus of your small f plus capital F minus of small f is equals to m into your a plus of your I into your A divided by your R square. So in this one and this one will get cancelled. F plus F, this will become for me 2F. That will be equal to your. A will be common in this one. It is M plus I by R square into your acceleration A. So that is equals to your M plus. What type of a body it is, beta? Tangential force acting on thin spherical shell. So when I'm talking about the spherical shell, for the shell, moment of inertia will be equal to how much? Like an hollow sphere. For hollow sphere, it is 2 by 3 into your m into your r square. So I can write that one value here. So it is 2 by 3 m into your r square divided by your r square into your a. R square will get cancelled. So it is your m plus 2m divided by 3 into your a. That means 2 by 3 plus 3. How much it will be beta? 5 by 3 into m into your a. That is your 2 times of your f. We need what right now for their acceleration? So f value will become how much for me beta? F value will become for me, f is equals to 5 into m into your a divided by 3 to the 6. So acceleration a will be equal to 6f divided by 5 into your m. So this will be the acceleration. Done? Good question. Try it once again. A tangential force F acts at the top of a thin spherical shell. So whenever I'm using a word spherical shell, that will be like of your hollow sphere. Okay, of mass M and radius R. The acceleration of the shell if it rolls without slipping. So for rolling without slipping or for pure rolling, acceleration will be equal to how much for me? R into your alpha. Isn't it? So now when it is rolling without slipping, applied force is in the friendly direction, frictional force also in the friendly direction. So for translational motion, capital F plus small f will be equal to m into your a. Why friction is in the friendly direction beta? Because it is rolling without slipping, so frictional force will be in the friendly direction. Then for rotation, this is your torque equation. This one is your force equation. So simplify this one, you'll get the answer for this. Clear? Chalo. The solid sphere, disc and solid cylinder, all of them of same mass and made up of same material are allowed to roll down from rest on inclined plane. Then solid sphere reaches the bottom first, solid sphere reaches the bottom late, disc will reach the bottom first, all of them will reach the bottom at the same time. Anyone? Whichever is having the lesser moment of inertia, that will be having more velocity. Check with the values of your k square by r square beta. K square by r square, if I am talking about for solid sphere, that is equals to moment of inertia for solid sphere. I is equals to 2 by 5 m into your r square. I is equals to m into k square, that is equals to 2 by 5 m into your r square. M gets cancelled. So k square divided by r square is equals to 2 by 5. For the disk, moment of inertia for the disk is m into r square divided by 2. That means m into your k square for the disk is equals to m into r square divided by 2. Mm gets cancelled. So k square divided by r square will be equal to 1 by 2. Okay. Yeah. Solid sphere will reach the bottom first. Because k square by r square value is minimum for your solid sphere. This value is your 0.5. Isn't it? That is lesser than that one. 2 by 5 means. So obviously, solid sphere will reach the bottom first. Next one. An inclined plane makes an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. Okay. This is your inclined plane. It makes an angle of 30 degrees with horizontal. Here a solid sphere is rolling. A solid sphere rolls down inclined plane from the rest. That means initial velocity will be equal to zero. Initial velocity will be equal to zero without slipping, has a linear acceleration equal to. Okay, acceleration formula I told you, A is equals to G into sine theta. For a body rolling without slipping, it is 1 plus K square divided by R square. Standard formula. Okay, theta value is given how much for me? 30 degrees. And what type of a body it is with a solid sphere? That means I is equals to 2 by 5 M into R square. Radius of gyration M into K square is equals to 2 by 5 m into your r square. M and m gets cancelled. So it is k square divided by r square is equals to 2 by 5. So acceleration will be A is equals to G into sine theta value is 30 degrees divided by 1 plus K square by R square is 2 by 5. Isn't it? So that will be equal to your G by 2. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. This will become for me how much? 1 by 2 plus 2 by 1 plus 2 by 5 is 7 by 5. So that will be equal to your how much for me, beta? 7 2s are 14. So that 5G will go up. So it is 5G divided by 14. Fourth option will be the answer. How many of you are giving the answer for that one? Very good. 5G by 14. So acceleration down the inclined plane. Try to remember this formula, beta. A is equals to your G into sine theta divided by 1 plus K square by R square. Next one. Uniform solid cylindrical roller of mass M is being pulled on a horizontal surface. Good question, beta. The uniform solid cylinder roller, solid cylindrical roller of mass M is being pulled on a horizontal surface. Okay. This is your horizontal surface. This is your roller. If I see from the front side, this will be the roller. I'll draw it once again. This one is surface. And here is your solid cylinder. Only front view I'm drawing. Radius of this one is R. Uniform solid cylindrical roller of mass of your M is being pulled on a horizontal surface with the force of your F. Okay, you are applying a force on this one as capital F parallel to the surface and is applied at its center. If acceleration of the cylinder is given as acceleration of this cylinder is A and it is rolling without slipping. Okay, this is important for me. It is rolling without slipping. When it is rolling without a slipping, what is the condition? A must be equal to your R alpha. A must be equal to your R into your alpha for rolling without slipping. Okay. Now, write me the forces acting on this body, beta. When you apply this force on this point, friction will be acting in the backward direction because you're applying the force at the center of mass. So if I'm writing the equation, capital F minus of small f will be equal to M into your A. This is your force equation.
So in the previous problem, we told that if it's rolling without slipping, the friction will act in the same direction.
It's you are applying the force on horizontal surface, on upper part, because it is sliding in the front direction, isn't it? So this point is exerting the force in the backward direction. So here we are slipping. The force is applied at the highest position, tangential force. So when the force is at the highest position, the frictional force will be in the same direction of your applied force. But now here we are applying the force in the center. Here we are applying the force in the center. That means the body is sliding in the front direction.
Okay, sir.
So frictional force is in the backward. So capital F minus small f is equal to M into A.
Yes,
now,
sir.
If I am writing the torque equation better, as it is also rotating, so torque equation will be equal to this frictional force into perpendicular distance. Torque because of applied force will be zero because it is passing through axis. So torque tau will be equal to your I into your alpha, isn't it? So torque will be equal to force into perpendicular, frictional force into perpendicular distance is equals to, as it is a solid cylinder, moment of inertia is M into R square divided by 2 into your alpha. Alpha value I can write from this one. So it is F into your R will be equal to M into your R square divided by 2 into alpha. Alpha is equals to your A by R. This R and this R will get cancelled right now here. So that will become for me M into A and this R also will get cancelled. So it is MA divided by 2 is F. That means F value I'm getting as F is equals to your M into your A divided by 2. This is the value of your friction. So therefore, we have got already the equation of the force, capital F minus small f is equal to M into A. This is my equation number one. This is my equation number 2. So substitute 2 in 1. Therefore, 2 in 1. Okay, so it is your capital F minus small f is m into your a divided by 2 is equals your how much beta m into your a. So f will be equal to your m into your a plus of your m a divided by 2. So m a common, it is 1 plus 1 by 2, that is 3 by 2. So it is 3 m a divided by 2 is your f. If he is asking acceleration, A will be equal to 2 into F divided by 3 into your M. If he is asking angular acceleration, A is equals to R into alpha. Alpha is equals to your A divided by R. A is equals to 2 into your F divided by 3M into your R. This will be the alpha. If he is asking the torque, tau will be equal to I into alpha. I is equals to m into r square divided by 2 into alpha. Alpha is 2 into f divided by 3m into your r. This m and this m will get cancelled. This 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. So it will be your f divided by f into your r. Because when r is left out, f into r divided by 3. Okay? Depending upon the data. But he is asking only the 4, so our answer will stop here itself. This is all extra which I told you if he is asking. Otherwise, F is equal to 3M into your A divided by 2. 3M into your A, 3 by 2. Third option will be the answer. Done? Next question. A body rolls down an inclined plane if its kinetic energy of rotation is 40% of its kinetic energy of the translation motion, then the body is how much? Again, good question, beta. This type of a questions you need to practice for your NEET examinations. A body rolls on an inclined plane. Okay, a body is rolling on an inclined plane. This is your theta. This is some body. When nothing is being given, we always take it as of your solid sphere, or else we can even calculate that one. That's not an issue. What is asking is, if its kinetic energy of the rotation is 40% of its kinetic energy of rotation is equals to 40% of its translational kinetic energy. Okay, that means k rotation divided by k translation is equals to 40%. That means 40 divided by 100. This one will get cancelled. 4 by 10, that is equals to 0.4. For the rotation, it will be equal to how much beta? Half into m into your v square into your k square divided by r square divided by translational. Translation is half into m into v square. That is equals to 0.4. m, and this one get cancelled. So k square by r square is equals to how much for me? 0.4 means 2 by 5. Okay, that means k square is equals to 2 by 5 times of your r square. So 2 by 5 r square is what beta? Solid sphere. So solid sphere will be the answer. I hope everyone got how I written this one, because kinetic energy due to rotation is half into I into omega square. That is equals to your half. I is moment of inertia in terms of radius of gyration k square. Omega is equals to v square by r square. That is the reason I have taken this one as half into m into v square common into your k square by your r square. That is how I got this relation there. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Sure. Next one. A solid cylinder of mass 2 kg and radius 0.1 meter rolls down an inclined plane of height 3 meter without slipping. Its rotational kinetic energy when it reaches the foot of the plane would be equal to your how much? A solid cylinder of mass 2 kg and radius 0.1 meter rolls down an inclined plane of height 3 meter without slipping. Its rotational kinetic energy when it reaches the foot of the plane would be equal to your how much? Good question, but again. Here is your solid cylinder. Mass is given for me 2 kg. Radius is given for me. Mass is equals to 2 kg. And radius is equals to 0.1 meter. rolls down inclined plane of height. Okay, height is also given for from where it is rolling down. So h will be equal to 3 meters without slipping. That means finally this body will come to the lowest position. Its rotational kinetic energy when it reaches the foot. Okay, it is rolling and moving in the front direction. So loss in potential energy, because it is coming from the highest position, na beta. Loss in potential energy will be equal to your gain in rotational kinetic energy. So that means mg into your h must be equal to half into m into square translating and also rotating, half into I into your omega square, isn't it? So if I'm writing this relation directly, so this will be equal to your mg into your h. Mg into your h is equals to half into m into v square plus half into what type of a body it is? Solid cylinder. For solid cylinder, moment of inertia is m into r square divided by 2 into omega. Omega is equals to v square by r square. This r square will get cancelled here right now. So this will be equal to your half into m into v square. This is your 2 plus this one is m into v square divided by 4. So 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 is how much beta? 3 by 4 m into v square. This is your mg into your h. M and m will get cancelled. Isn't it? So what I'm getting right now for me? G into your h will be equal to your how much? What is asking in the plane? Its rotational kinetic energy will be equal to your how much? Okay. Rotational kinetic energy will be equal to how much beta? Half into m into v square. Okay. G into your h will be equal to 3 by 4 into v square. So rotational kinetic energy. Rotational kinetic energy is 1 by 4 m into v square. That is equals to 1 by 4. What is the value I got here right now? V square value I can write from this one. Okay, it is 4g into h divided by 3 is equals to v square. Substitute this value, 4g into your h. It is your m into 4g into your h divided by how much? 3. Divided by 3. This 4 will get cancelled. So this is mg into h divided by 3. So this is your rotational kinetic energy answer. Has it given the data for this one, beta? What is the data given for me? Rotational kinetic energy. Mass is given for me. Radius is given. Height is given. Okay, everything is given for me. Mass value is equals to how much for me? 2. G value is 9.8. Height is given for me. How much in the problem? What is the height given for me? Height is 3 meters. Okay. Height is your 3 divided by 3. This 3 will get cancelled. So that will be equal to 19.6 joules or approximately 20. So D will be the answer. Done? Sure. Next one. The acceleration of the disc rolling down an inclined plane of angle theta without a slipping. Acceleration of disc is asking. So what is the formula, beta? Acceleration direct formula. A is equals to g into sine theta divided by 1 plus of your k square divided by r square. So that is equals to g into your sine theta divided by 1 plus. For the disk, moment of inertia will be equal to I is equals to m into r square divided by 2. So it is m into your k square is equals to m into r square divided by 2. Mm gets cancelled. So k square by r square will be equal to your 1 by 2. That means this will be equal to your 1 by 2. 1 plus 1 by 2 is how much for me? 3 by 2. That means this will become for me 2g into sine theta divided by 3. 2 by 3g into sine theta. Very good. Varunya is giving the answer. Chalo. Next one. A ball rolls without slipping. The radius of gyration of the ball about an axis passing through its center of mass is k. If radius of the ball be b, then the fraction of total energy associated with its rotational energy will be equal to how much? I hope you can do this question better. Is asking your kinetic energy of the rotation due to the total kinetic energy. Fraction of total energy associated with rotation. That means it is total energy. So it will be equal to your half of your m into v square, half into I into your omega square divided by half into m into v square into, this is 1 plus of your k square by r square. I just told you how to write this one in terms of half into m into v square into, this one is k square divided by your r square divided by, this one is half into m into v square into 1 plus of your k square divided by r square. Half mv square will get cancelled. So this will be equal to how much for me beta? K square divided by this one is your r square into, this one is your r square plus k square into your r square will get cancelled. So this will be equal to k square divided by k square plus of your r square. So which option I can write beta? Option B, very good. K square by k square plus r square. B will be the answer for this one. Next one. A sphere rolls down an inclined plane of inclination theta. This is not 6, this is theta. What is the acceleration of the sphere on reaching the bottom? Anyone? Direct question. Acceleration is asking again, same formula. A is equals to g into sine theta divided by 1 plus k square by r square. What type of a body? Sphere. For sphere, moment of inertia is 2 by 5 m into r square. I will be equal to mr square, that is equals to 2 by 5 m into your r square. M and m gets cancelled. So this one is k square, sorry. This one is k square. K square divided by r square will be equal to 2 by 5. So that will be equal to g into sine theta divided by 1 plus 2 by 5. 1 plus 2 by 5 is how much beta?
7 by 5.
7 by 5. That means 5 will go up. So it is 5g into sine theta divided by 7. So first option will be the answer. Done? Okay. Next one. A hollow, smooth, uniform sphere A of mass m rolls without sliding on a smooth horizontal surface. It collides head-on elastically. So elastic collision means momentum is conserved, kinetic energy is also conserved. With another stationary smooth solid sphere B. Okay. Mass m and radius and same radius. Okay. The ratio of kinetic energy of the B to that of your A just after the collision will be equal to how much? What will be the answer? A hollow, smooth, uniform sphere A of mass m rolls without sliding on a smooth horizontal surface. It collides head-on elastically with another stationary smooth solid sphere. This one is solid sphere and this one is a hollow, smooth, uniform. That means moment of inertia for the hollow will be equal to 2 by 3 m into your r square. For solid, it will be equal to 2 by 5 into m into r square. Okay, so as the collision is elastic beta, after the collision, the first body will come to the rest. But there will be the rotation for this one. Okay, what is asking is the ratio of kinetic energy. Okay, ratio of kinetic energy of the B divided by the ratio of kinetic energy of your A. Okay, see, as the collision is in elastic beta, so initial kinetic energy of the first body will become zero and it will transfer its velocity to the second body and starts rotating. So kinetic energy of the B means solid sphere, 2 by 5 m into your square. First one is hollow, 2 by 3 m into your r square. Mr square, mr square will get cancelled, 2 and 2 will get cancelled, so it is 3 by 5. Am I doing any mistake there, Peter? The ratio of kinetic energy of the B to that of your A. So B is having both rotation and also kinetic energy, na? Sorry. See, as the collision is your elastic, the first body will come to the rest after the collision. That means translation kinetic energy will become zero. As collision is elastic, so velocity of A will become zero. Velocity of the B will become for me V. It will transfer its velocity to that body. That means body B has both kinetic and energy rotation. So kinetic energy of A will be equal to only half of your I into omega square. Kinetic energy of the B will be equal to half into M into V square plus also half into I into your omega square. Is asking the ratio of kinetic energy of the B to that of your A. Okay. Kinetic energy of your B divided by kinetic energy of your A. So that will be equal to half into M into V square plus half into I into omega square divided by half into I into omega square. This is moment of inertia A, moment of inertia B. It is equals to half M V square. If I take common, it is 1 plus of your K square by R square divided by half into moment of inertia is M into your K square into omega square. Omega is equals to V by R. Okay, I'll just write the values here. Get the confusion otherwise. That will be equal to half into M into V square into 1 plus. Second body is what? Solid sphere, not 2 by 5 divided by. This one will be half into M into V square into A square by R square. Hollow sphere will be 2 by 3. MR square will get cancelled. This will become for me how much? 1 plus 2 by 5 is how much, beta?
7 by 5.
7 by 5 divided by. For hollow sphere, it will be equal to how much? For hollow sphere, it is 2 by 3 MR square. So it is M into your K square will be equal to 2 by 3 MR square. MM gets cancelled. So K square by R square will be 2 by 3. So this will be your 2 by 3. So how much it will be, beta? No, tell me in fraction only. Options are 1 is to 1, 2 is to 3. This is 7 by 5 into 3 by 2. 7 3 is 21, 21 divided by 10. It means 2.1. Isn't it?
So it can be 2 is to 1 approximately.
2 is to 1. 2.1 is 2 is to 1. So which option I can write here? 2 is to 1 is not there. 1 is to 1, 3 is to 2, none of this. So none of this must be the answer. Don't know what is the answer given for this one. Let me check it out once. C he has given, 3 is to 2. Am I doing any mistake there, is here? Hollow smooth uniform sphere A of mass M. This one is hollow, okay. This one is your solid. Mass M rolls without sliding on a smooth horizontal surface. It collides without sliding. Down collision, so stationary, solid sphere. Same radius, ratio of kinetic energy of the B to that of your A. Kinetic energy of the B will be having both rotation and translational. And A will be having only rotation. A will be having only rotation. Half omega square. Omega square is V square by R square. M into your R square. Yeah, I'll check it out later. This is theory question. You can try it once. Okay. Try this question, beta. 16th one. A solid cylinder of mass M and radius R rolls down an inclined plane without slipping. The speed of its center of mass when it reaches the bottom will be equal to your how much? solid sphere of mass m and radius r rolls down an inclined plane without slipping. That means loss in potential energy must be equal to gain in rotational kinetic energy and translation. That means mg into your h must be equal to half into m into v square plus half into I into omega square. So that will be equal to half into m into v square plus half into your I. Omega is equals to v square by your r square. What type of a body it is? Solid cylinder. So that will be equal to half into m into your v square. Plus half into solid sphere moment of inertia is 2 by 5 m into your r square into v square by r square. R square will get cancelled. So it is half into m into v square is common. 1 plus of your 2 by 5. Half m v square common. So 1 plus 2 by 5 is how much for me, beta? 7 by 5. That means it is 7 m v square divided by 7 by 5, 5 2 is a 10. So this is your mg into your h. He is asking velocity, na? So speed of the body without slipping, the speed of the center of mass of this body will be equal to how much? Solid cylinder it is, sorry, not a sphere. Solid cylinder means moment of inertia will be equal to how much, beta? Moment of inertia will be changing there. So for solid cylinder it is m into r square divided by 2 into v square divided by r square. R square will get cancelled. Half into m into v square will be common into 1 plus 1 by 4, isn't it? So no, 1 plus 1 by 4, half mv square is common, 1 plus half, 1 by 2, sorry. Isn't it? Half mv square, 1 plus 1 by 2 is common, that means 3 by 2. Isn't it? 3 mv square divided by 2, 2 into 2, this will become for 4. N and M will get cancelled. So 2G into your H will be equal to 3 into V square. Sorry, 4, no? Y2. This one is 4. 4GH is equals to 3 into V square. 4G into H is equals to 3 into V square. What is asking there? Velocity. So V is equals to V square is equals to 4G into H divided by 3. So V is equals to under root of 4G into H divided by 3. So this will be the velocity. Option B. Let me check. Yeah, option B will be the answer. Yeah. Check it out once again. He is using solid cylinder. Solid cylinder moment of inertia is I is equals to MR square divided by 2. Done. The ratio of acceleration of solid sphere rolling down inclined plane of angle theta without slipping and slipping down inclined without rolling. This we can try it out better, general question. This also you can try. This also you just take an option and try to do it out. This is something like good question, I think. See. A cylinder of mass MC, that means mass of cylinder, and a sphere of mass MS, mass of cylinder is MS, are placed at a point A and B on the two inclines respectively. See the figure. Okay. If they roll on an incline without slipping, such that their accelerations are same, then the ratio of sine theta C divided by sine theta S, that means cylinder to that of sphere. What is an acceleration formula for this one, beta? A is equals to your g into sine theta divided by your 1 plus of your k square divided by your r square. Isn't it? So if I'm writing the acceleration of the cylinder, that will be equal to g into your sine theta divided by 1 plus. for what cylinder na cylinder moment of inertia is equals to how much beta k square by r square will be equal to your solid cylinder I will be equal to your m r square divided by 2 so it is m into k square is equals to m into r square divided by 2 so this will get cancelled k square by r square will be equal to 1 by 2 so this will be equal to 1 by 2 so it will be equal to 3 by 2 so it is 2g this one will be 3 by 2 so this will become for me 2g into sin theta divided by 3 this is the acceleration of the cylinder for sphere if I am talking about acceleration of your sphere is equals to g into sin theta divided by 1 plus 2 by 5 I hope you remember this one isn't it so that will be equal to your how much for me One plus two by five, seven by five. So that will become for me 5g into sin theta divided by 7. So given in the problem is acceleration of the cylinder is equals to acceleration of the sphere. That means 2/3g into sin of your theta c will be equal to your 5/7g into sin of your theta of your sphere. G and g will get cancelled. So this will be equal to how much beta sin theta c divided by sin theta 5 will be equal to this will be equal to 5 into 3 divided by 7 into 2 5 3 is a 15 divided by 7 2 is a 14 15 by 14 fourth option then okay beta this sunday you write an examination on rotational mechanics beta I have given lot of your problems also practice part you please try to revise them and even dpps I think you might have been got in your app you can just see it out and try to solve the numericals of your rotational dynamics almost all the models we have been completed I think still how many days is the rotational mechanics beta can anyone tell me nandini still how many days is the rotational mechanics teaching beta till what date it is Take care, beta. Bye.